During World War II, the German U-boat played a crucial role in impeding Allied shipping as U-boat packs hunted on the open seas. What was problematic for the U-boat was how far the crew could see being so close to the ocean surface, unlike the view from the top of the superstructure of a destroyer. So the Germans developed a strange mechanical kite, which would be fitted to U-boats, giving them the ability to see further than the enemy. In the years leading up to the Second World War, research into the viability of the helicopter as a beneficial aircraft design had been limited. Of the few who were dedicated to researching and developing helicopter designs were two Germans, aircraft designer Heinrich Fokker and test pilot Gerd Aktgelis. Together they formed the helicopter company Fokker Aktgelis, which would develop many concepts during the Second World War. Among their designs was a small helicopter-like design with no motor, known as a rotor kite. This kite would be designated FA-330. Using airflow, the propellers on the aircraft could be spooled up to a sufficient speed and then used to generate enough downforce to take off. This would be achieved by tugging the kite behind a boat or car. As the war went on, German interest in the concept of rotary wing aircraft deepened. With this came new ideas and even working concepts, but it would be the FA-330 which would see active service. Having proven itself as a simple and effective aircraft, the FA-330 was approved for military use in mid-1942. The design was simple, yet beneficial. Weighing 180 pounds, it was stowed in a watertight compartment under the U-boat's tower. The FA-330 would be brought into the middle of the deck and assembled. This could be done with just two crew members, and in the right conditions, its assembly would take only 4 minutes. It would then be tethered to a 160-meter cable, allowing it to reach its standard operating altitude of 120 meters. Once assembled and tethered, the FA-330 could use the airflow generated by the moving U-boat to spin its rotors, gaining momentum until a sufficient speed was achieved. The pitch could then be adjusted, and the rotor kite would take off. At 120 meters in the air, the FA-330 operator would be able to see 25 nautical miles in any direction. In contrast, the U-boat with its low profile could only see 5 nautical miles. Using a phone connected to the U-boat, the pilot could then relay what they were seeing down to the crew. If the captain of the U-boat was forced to abandon the rotor kite, for example in the case of an emergency dive, the tether would be released and the FA-330 would slowly descend down to the surface of the water, keeping its pilot safe. In case of other failures, the pilot could jettison the rotor hub and blades, which would automatically release a parachute when separated. Upon releasing his safety belt, the pilot could safely descend. Over the course of the war, 200 would be produced and would primarily see use in the Indian Ocean and Southern Atlantic, where the threat of Allied patrol aircraft was limited. On the 5th of August 1943, the FA-330 would achieve its first and only recorded sinking when it spotted Ephthalia Mari, a Greek steamer, off the coast of Madagascar. Out of visual range for the U-boat crew on the surface, the steamer was spotted by the FA-330 operator, who relayed its position to the crew of U-177, who adjusted heading and sunk the ship. Other successful uses of the FA-330 may have occurred, but they were not recorded. As Allied air power in the Atlantic grew stronger, the use of the FA-330 became ever more limited. Attempting to get back on board before spotted Allied aircraft came within firing range of the U-boat, pilots of the FA-330 would be forced to crash land at speeds which could be fatal. Thus, it was decided to limit its use. This impeded a proposal by Fokker Aktgelis to design a motor-powered version, which would have been known as the FA-336. Eventually, due to this same issue of time constraints once enemy aircraft or destroyers had been spotted, the Kriegsmarine decided to abandon the project. However, the legacy of the FA-330 did not end there. Because of its simple and unique design, it would go on to influence the future development of autogiros and rotor kites, which would later be called gyrocopters. After capturing the U-boat U-852 in 1944, the British began testing the captured FA-330, which was tugged behind their own ships and jeeps. Eventually, the British interest would be redirected towards the development of helicopters. However, the FA-330 concept remained influential. Chief among these autogiro designers inspired by the aircraft was Igor Benson, founder of Benson Aircraft, who had the opportunity to look over the FA-330 in 1946. This directly inspired his eventual development of one-man autogyros, in particular the Benson B-8, which he would become famous for. Today, rotor kites and autogyros continue to be researched and developed into increasingly efficient machines. Although they have largely been forgotten by the military, civilian operators continue to push the idea forward, with autogyros setting world records, such as flying across the Atlantic and traveling across the globe. Once again, we see innovation under the pressure of war produce the most remarkable ideas in our pursuit to master the skies.